What?
You white one. Look like you got soused up.
I'm listening. What do you come to me with?
Got news of your wife.
Plowing hell, why'd you not say so forthwith? Where is she? Why have you not returned with her?
She's in Crookback Bog. Got food, a place to live, and keeps herself busy. Didn't look like she had the slightest desire to leave.
You were to bring her back, not report on the condition she lives under!
I was supposed to find her, and I did. That was our deal, nothing more.
You still think me rotten to the core? A base bastard, don't you? You believe I alone am at fault for what happened here?
Doesn't matter what I believe.
Yet, looking at you, I see contempt. Can't speak for the world you witches inhabit, but in ours, nothing is ever black and white.
Probably gonna say you're not the only one to blame. All right then, I'm willing to hear your side of the story.
With Annie, it was love at first sight. A spear tore through my shoulder at the Battle of Anchor. She tended to my wound. Once I'd recovered, I asked her to marry me. She wept with joy. Soon after, Tamara was born. And after that, they sent me to Sidaris. A warlord had risen against King Ethan, and Foltest sent help. It was one battle to the next, one conflict after another. It was a life of war. I was seldom home, and I found comfort in drink. Grew so fond of hooch, I couldn't part with it when I did get home.
All right. What then?
I went from front to front, battle to battle, collecting soldiers' coin, while Anna sat alone with the babe for months. Later, I learned she'd not been so alone after all. For nearly 3 years, she'd found comfort in the arms of one Evan, a childhood friend, a dog's bunghole. Understand, dammit? One tussle in the hay I'd have waved aside, put it out of my mind. But the woman cuckolded me for years, without a whisker of concern for me, for my love.
How'd you find out?
Came home one day and Anna was gone. The things too. Found a letter. She wrote that she didn't love me. That she'd left me for that knob licker and taken Tamara with her. Felt like I'd been rammed in the arse by a horse. I went to find the bugger, to get the girls back, bring them home. Yet soon as I saw him, something turned inside me, something dark. I slaughtered the shit-eating twat and fed his carcass to the dogs.
Imagine Anna wasn't exactly pleased.
Ha! Bloody understatement if I've ever heard one. She flew into a fit, hysteria, threw herself at me, kicking and clawing. Finally grabbed a knife. It would have been the end of me if I'd not leapt aside. It was the first time I hit her. I had to calm her. Felt I had no other means. Things changed. They would never be the same. Anna tried to take her own life, and mine, several times. She would prod me, goad me, taunt me, in the hope I would hit her again, perhaps.
I should scream that I'd robbed her a life of love, that I'd destroyed the idea for her, and so might as well kill her. How many times I apologized. How many armfuls of blooms and gifts I brought. She cared not a bit. 2 years of her anger had turned to indifference, broken at times were her bouts of hysteria and my bouts of drunkenness. Cannot fathom how we survived those years, but we did. Though, as you know now, not everything was as it might have seemed.
You're right. Faults on both sides, yours and hers.
I'm content that you finally see that. Very well then. If you won't bring Anna home, you might at least tell me how she landed in that blasted swamp.
She made a pact with the Crones and... well, I think she might have lost her mind.
A pact? What the bloody hell?
She was with child. A child she didn't want to bear. Went to the Crones for help. They promised to rid her of the problem in exchange for a year of her service. And they kept their word, in their own twisted way.
What do you mean?
Anna must have thought the child inside her would somehow disappear. Instead, the Crones sapped her of strength, and ultimately forced her body to miscarry. I think that's when she started to lose her mind. Then they placed magic tethers on her. Tethers that cause great pain when tested. A guarantee she'll pay off her debt.
A pact with witches? Bloody nightmare, sounds like some jest. We must get her out. We can't leave her there.
Do what you will, but leave me out of this. You ask me, wading through the swamp to mess with the Crones, just plain stupid.
What would you have me do? Sit on my ass and wait for her return? I'll send men, go with them myself, and we will pull her out.
I've warned you. What you do, that's your business. We had a deal. I've done my part. Your turn to do yours.
A word once given. Now, what did I last?
Basilisk. It had just attacked you.
Ah, right. Gargantuan. One solid brute. Survive this, you're to take whatever you want from the fortress.
You'll survive.
Let's show this bastard what we're worth.
Oh!
You have everything?
Yes, thank you.
What you did for me, I shall never forget it.
I certainly hope not. It's brought me no small trouble.
Meaning?
I must flee. Wraiths pursue me. The Wild Hunt. I was foolish to use the power. They're sure to have caught my scent.
The Wild Hunt? Pursuing you?
I'll endanger all of you by remaining here. You must tell the people to bar their doors and windows. And no one is to wander the night.
And you? Where do you think you're going?
Now, I ride for Novigrad. And then, who knows where.
She mounted and rode off. It grew awfully empty without her.
Redanian armies blocked the Pontar crossing, yet you sent Ciri to Novigrad.
She was looking for a sorceress, and all of them are in Novigrad. Besides, I didn't leave her at the Redanians' mercy. I gave her a letter of safe conduct.
So there's a chance Ciri's still in Novigrad. Thanks for helping her.
It's nothing. Now you've learned what you wanted to know, you must be in a hurry. But if you could...
Spit it out.
I want to go get Anna. Free her, bring her back. I don't believe she's there willingly.
Must have not heard me. Any journey into the swamp is suicide.
I heard you, which is why I could use your aid. I've no more tales of Ciri to offer you, but go with me and I'll be generous with what I do have. Very generous.
Extra coin never hurt.
Ha! True indeed. I'll round up my men and ride to Down Warren. You can join us there.
Fine. Sounds good.
Sorry, we was never here.
What was that?
You tell me. Man or monster? My men call him Uma and say he's a beast. But he seems a man to me. Just hideous as Ardle's shit.
Doesn't look like a monster, but my medallion's trembling. Strange. Where'd you find him?
Funny story, actually. I won him in a game of cards.
Funny story? How so?
Went to Novigrad once, to rest, indulge in the city's pleasures. Stayed at a tavern, and some folk there were playing, so I joined in. Cards were kind that day. Had one devilish hand after another. Robbed the horsons blind. One fellow, a merchant, took it especially hard. He'd gambled away everything he'd brought from Skelliger. Wanted terribly to play another hand, so I agreed. Asked him what he had to wager, and he showed me that sideshow. Not much in it for me, but fuck it, I thought. I'll give the man a chance to win something back. Luck was not with him. And Uma wound up here at Crow's Perch. End of story.
Proper baron now. Even got a jester.
Aye. Though I feel something's not right with him.
How so?
Well, he seems more beast than man. But there's wisdom, cunning in the bastard's eyes. Or maybe I'm imagining it. Ever run into anything like him?
No, but he doesn't look dangerous.
I guess that's that. Doesn't eat much, so as long as he's no trouble, the boys might as well have some diversion.
Time I was on my way. So long.
Farewell. I hope you find your daughter. And prove a good father to her.
Baron gets sad. He gets angry. And he's always drinking.
Fancy a gander at our little stockpile.
Show me what you got. See ya.
How can I help you?
What are you selling? What's good? Take care now. Thank you.
Sir? Ye deaf? Be gone, you blasted mutant.
Where's all this hate for witchers coming from?
Where? I'll tell ye where. One of yous came here, ate his fill for 2 days while he thunk things over. Then he says he'd do us a favor and kill our monster. What's your price? I asked. But he said he wanted no coin, for he saw we'd none to offer.
Awfully noble of him.
Thought so too, at first. Said for pay he'd take something I had that did not yet know about. Then he left. And here the door swung shut behind him. Me lass started wailing. What's these tears, I asked. Oh, I can't bear it, she says. I'll kill the horsen.
Go on.
Fool girl wept that some beast was gonna kill the witcher dead. Ye howling for a mutant, I said. Then she told me, bugger had bewitched her with his evil eye, seduced her, and that were to be his prize. A witcher's bastard.
Tell me where he is. Take care of this for you.
Cemetery. Went there to slay the monster. Hope the corpse eater guts that fornicated freak. Not one of the Baron's men, are you?
Oh,
sir.
Strange.
Thank you. You came just in time. A moment more and that gull would have filleted me like a flounder.
Actually, not sure I should have intervened. Your combat style, it's new to me. Should have just observed. Where'd you complete your training? School of the Snail? But then where'd you get your wolf's head medallion?
You're the real thing? A witcher?
Mm-hmm. What gave it away? That I didn't wet my trousers at the sight of one lousy ghoul? Answer the question. Where'd you get the medallion?
I bought it from a traveling peddler. Oh, villagers are coming. Don't tell him about me, please.
Monster slain! Oi, what's this? Two witchers? We only hired one.
Only one witcher here. This man's a charlatan. Travels from village to village cheating people.
No, it's not like that. I can explain everything I can.
He's a crook, a fraud. Oh, we've laws for this kind. Special punishments. Thank ye for exposing him, Master Witcher.
Let him go, this time.
Never again, I swear.
He's a halfwit, ain't he? Going after a ghoul?
Things would be simple if the ghoul had torn him apart. As it is, we've got ourselves a moral dilemma.
Let him go, but don't ye come near our village. We'll set the hounds on you if you do. Is that clear? Yeah?
Thank you.
Get out of my sight.